Hey, bro. Exactly what you said, but I'm prepared for that. Because at the end of the day, now I can really just go to war. Like, I can really go to war for a cause.
Yeah.
See what I'm saying? Like, bro, if you don't understand that ain't my kid, you about this shit, bro. You are
what I'm saying. And that's
right
why I
now.
I think we got more power now, because for a while it was only people of a certain age group, but you was a little young probably when Trayvon happened, but you got to
but
see
I
it.
Understood.
You understood.
I understood
that
what
ain't
was going
right.
on.
That could have been me.
So now think about it like this.
Did you ain't see Rodney King?
I ain't see Rodney King. Now we would have had 100 people that was on the same shit, like demanding on some shit, like, bro, you telling me you, like how he even said it, like they are afraid. Why is that the first thing that come to your mind if you supposed to be the police officer and you afraid of niggas you protect?
Hey, bro.
The fuck,
hey,
nigga?
Fly. They don't see us as human beings. It's like this.
That's
it's like
crazy.
This. Roach, I know you fuck with roaches, but right. Roach running in somebody's house, they kill it. Automatic. Don't know why.
They don't know why.
Don't have no reason to kill
they
it.
They don't even know that motherfucker. It's not bothering you. You
nigga,
are an expert.
You'll trip if somebody look at you and say, man, why the fuck you step on that roach? You be like, nigga, what you mean? It's a roach. That's how they look at us. So we trying to reason with motherfuckers that ain't got no reason. Like, nigga on the debate team.
Right.
They say you got to attack a person's reason in order to get them to change their mind. I can't change a racist mind
because he don't
have no reason to hate me.
I was just, well, hey, what we were driving over here saying, bro, because niggas saying the same shit. I said, bro.
Man, you turn this Seinfeld ass shit off.
That shit hilarious,
that shit white as fuck.
Bro.
Don't niggas, turn off that Coca-Cola.
I'm
journey.
Like, these niggas talking some real shit right now.
Niggas
need Lisa Simpson ass theme song.
Bro,
you fucking up my gangsterism, man.
Fucking up my gangsterism.
Nah, we was on some revolutionary shit,
we
bro.
We still there. Like, that's just for example, like the white people, they here waking up with just pure hatred in their fucking, and like, I got some white friends. I understand that, but it's majority of people who's got the cover up, like, hey, how you doing? That's really trying to be like, you ain't got a problem with it, but knowing you got a problem with it because you voted for a motherfucker who's part of the white supremacy.
It's less us against white now. It's people versus the authority. This is the first time in a long time that white people been fucked up too, been broke, been at the house, can't make no money. So now they feel marginalized just like we do. It's three types of white people. You got white people that like black people, white people that hate black people, and white people that
tolerate
don't give a fuck.
Black people.
Yeah, or they don't even care what happened to you, live or die.
Yeah, it's neutral.
The motherfuckers that care, they seeing shit now because they fucked up.
They're like, oh shit, this is happening. They fucked up, but they realize who really run the economy. You dig what I'm saying? And it's like, if they not working, then it affects us.
Come on.
Which has been like that from the jump, nigga. If we were to choose to not go pick cotton, yo, bitch ass ain't gonna go out there and pick no cotton because you can't stand the sun too long.
Right.
You gonna burn. Your skin gonna start.
Straight up.
You dig what I'm saying? So you need a certain particular group of people to go do your hard labor for you.
Nigga, this whole country built
that. That's what minimum wage is.
Nigga, that's what slavery is.
I can minimum wage you to death. Nigga, I can have a whole business, minimum wage you, no salary, no bonus, no net. I'm a minimum wage you for life.
Or I'm gonna make you build this my whole entire land up that I got over here. I'm gonna take my
never
money
told us what was going on. Just use our creative thinking. When you seen the nigga was doing something unordinary than the rest of the team, you like, hold up. You seen the way Billy Bernard down there?
Hey, you know that's that liquor now.
was fucking with that damn dirt.
Yeah.
They watched nigga was, we had that many resources. Nigga was building shit out of dirt. And nigga was like, hi, come teach that to me right quick. Because you don't have the resources that I got to make this dirt foundation become something. Mm-hmm. So now you're an architect.
You have.
Been an architect. You got me, you been an architect.
I forgot we talking
about. But you been standing out here for so long.
Hey, Lose, I don't know what's going on.
You
wait a minute, man. You are all over the place. Welcome back to the 85 South Show. I don't know what the fuck these things are talking about, man.
You lost. My boy been in the streets. You from Mississippi. You out of all people should know. Mississippi? Shit, they been keeping shit from y'all niggas so long.
What you mean?
Shit. Mississippi is the racist place and the most niggerish place in the United States of America.
Ah, man.
If you want to take any state,
that was
you're
an
like,
amazing sentence.
Who
nigga.
You think is the most racist place in the United States? You're like, nigga, don't go to Mississippi.
Mississippi the one. Mississippi burning.
But Mississippi? That shit sound like they still resting. Mississippi, you better not say
I can't believe you saying that sitting in Georgia. Nigga, the whole South is the same
the
place.
South.
That's what I'm saying, but we covered up industrialized, though. You see what I'm saying? Like, it's covered up, but we know exactly where not to go. Like, when you say certain cities, shh, what? Who? Don't go over there. You go over here. Yes, it's people who are racist because they have their own personal business, so they don't have to hire you. They don't have to do that. Of course, they're going to show their power because they are in power. This they shit. But if we had our shit, they would see it would affect their dollar. We wouldn't be over there. You see what I'm saying? And we not the minority, nigga. They told us that. How can we be the minorities when everything we touch, it spreads? Everything we touch, plural. How we minority? No, that was a wealth class. Minor,
it's harder
majority.
For the, it's harder
that was
for
a
white
wealth
people,
class.
It's harder for white people to
start. Don't get these folks twisted. Yeah. We not minors, man. It's minors come from people who that's a poor class. Everybody poor. You dig what I'm saying?
It's harder to teach your kids racist values when their heroes is LeBron James, Jay-Z, Tupac. You know what I'm saying? They growing up on different people that they idolizing as
right,
as
my
kids.
Dad hero was Red Fox.
Yeah, but your daddy black. I'm saying though. Right. A white person.
Oh, you talking about white people? Oh.
Yeah, my nigga, my bad. You was on your shit, my
fault. Yeah, my bad.
Yeah,
now
I'm just saying, like, it's we're getting more white people that seeing the struggle and the revolution and shit because they're unable to be raised in that way because their favorite person in the world is LeBron James. Their favorite person in the world is Michael Jackson.
Right.
Like, black people are in the forefront. So we are the minority in terms of total population, but in terms of fucking popularity.
No, listen,
not really
listen,
in population.
Because
everything we touch,
guys,
nigga, if you go fuck a white woman right now, nigga, that baby black.
Guys.
How the hell we minority, nigga? We are the majority.
Guys.
White
guys,
people came up with the 1% rule.
Relax,
so
guys.
If anything,
guys.
So
guys,
if anything, so if anytime a white
guys
person
ain't
get
saying
touched,
shit.
That motherfucker ain't pure. Who's the minority?
Guys, relax. You guys are making some great points. you're just all you're all over the place right now. Guys,
no, we on the same page.
Get them guys, together, we're all the over the page. Place right
Stop
now.
Stop saying guys, my nigga.
Guys,
I said two sentences.
I don't know what the fuck they were about. Listen, guys, we're all over the place right now.
That's
know,
where we at, though.
I know everybody's
roll the blunt
angry,
so I can still
angry.
Drive all over the place.
Angry.
I want to smoke.
I know everyone's angry
get my
right
revolutionary
now,
on. I've been fighting.
Let's direct this a little bit.
I'm ready
well,
to
I
go.
I see you got your riot
you
rag
see my
rag?
I ain't bullshit.
You know
what? I was at the protest. I went down there. Right among the people, watching.
Where you was at?
Getting them.
It's been
downtown.
It's been a lot going on, man.
Watching, getting the people together. Come here, buddy. Hey, I'm pulling niggas shorts. Hey, nigga, looking around. Nigga, look left. Nigga
look left.
Fuck you doing all that like a fly around? You left. Hey, you looking at left. Listen to me. Listen, look straight and listen to me. Nigga like, what? Look straight, listen to me. I'm talking to the side. Look straight, listen to me. Mm-hmm.
Look straight and listen
look
to me.
Look straight and listen to me. For real.
Now,
come
guys,
on.
There's protests going on all over the world right now. People are upset. And
appreciate it, too.
About the, they should be.
Mm-hmm.
Because, man, this is, we really watching death.
I'm talking about live, though.
And it's just like this shit is every other day we watching another black person
they triggering
die
us.
Right in front
me
of us.
Me and you old enough to remember where they couldn't show dead people on TV. Remember that shit?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I feel like it was illegal. They either had to have a sheet on or it was blurred
shit
out.
Been
we
going
are seeing
on.
Actual physical murders.
But see, you got to keep in mind, you said our generation, bro, we've been around to watch all the police brutality since it's been available.
Right.
Since Rodney King.
Mm-hmm. I was just gonna say the Rodney King shit was just crazy. Like it brings power to even to like even see that type of shit. Like I'm young.
Yeah. That was 90. What year was that?
92.
I was 91.
91 when he got beat up. 92 was the riots.
91 when he got. I wasn't even born then.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? And to even watch them beat a nigga trying to fight for his life just to get up and hit a nigga with the billy club. And he fall again, like, what type of enjoyment you
Natasha
get out
Hawley
shit,
was the first murder I saw on television, if y'all don't know about that. Natasha Hawley is a young black girl in New York, man. She was talking to a Korean store owner, and you know what I mean? Cursed her out a little bit and all that. And when she turned around, the Korean store owner shot her in the back. You can see it. Shot her right in the back. And that was a huge thing. And that was the first time in my age that I saw a murder on television.
Right.
Yeah. And you don't really get to see white people get murdered on TV either.
Oh, she was white?
Nah, she was black. Oh. I'm trying to see if anybody ever seen a white person murdered.
Hell no.
The one guy in the hotel. The one guy in the hotel?
Who?
The
guy
in the hotel hallway. He had the BB gun.
Yes.
I ain't see that one. They ain't televised that one.
Unarmed,
right there.
Unarmed. But that's it. Yeah. If
I ain't see that. I seen the one when the white boy had the rifle and he was wrestling with the police. Y'all seen that one? Yeah, I seen that one. I'm like, damn, but he went up to that nigga like a scared cat.
But there's just been so many instances of police brutality since these protests have started, from them tear gassing the peaceful protests to them, you know, entrapping them in certain places, like the shit that happened with Clayton. That. And getting trapped up on the roof and shit. And
yeah.
What happened?
Oh, I wasn't talking about that. Nigga, Clay was on the roof last night, bro.
Wow.
My nigga, he was protesting. The curfew was 9. In the middle of it, they said the curfew was 8 o'clock. Right. So it was a lot of people obviously trying to get home. Right. He was on the street that he lives on. The police was cutting off streets, started shooting the rubber bullets at him, tear gas. A white lady let everybody up onto her roof
right.
to just keep him safe. And then they was up there for a few hours, and the police came in the house and took all them people outside, like on some real took them outside, searched them, I'm sure they looked for warrants and shit, you know, had them handcuffed.
But you said the curfew, we inside. You said the curfew.
But they ain't their house.
And?
No, you arguing with the wrong nigga.
I know, but I'm saying, I'm with you. No, I ain't arguing. I'm just speaking in general. Nigga, we spend the night.
Nah, but they had helicopters on them and everything. Shit was on the news. That's bro, Clayton was on what the I'm news, saying? Man.
But that's what I'm trying to tell you. They came up with a system in order for them to be like, it's okay to do this shit. We're going to come up with a 9 o'clock rule, right? And say these niggas got to go home at 9 o'clock. Now, we pay everybody. Now, you going to tell me when to go the fuck home?
Yeah.
When it's 24 hours in the day, and you going to say go home at 9. All right.
Yeah, because
it's 9:15. I'm on my way home, though, nigga. I stay an hour and a half away. Nigga, I ain't know you made this rule, nigga, at 8 o'clock. You dig what I'm saying? All right.
Yeah.
So now it's a problem. Come on my way home, and you feel like
you never get to talk to the police that long.
Right. You see what I'm saying?
You're saying a lot of words.
They yanking your ass out. You dig what I'm saying? So, yeah. But for me to be a citizen and I'm paying my taxes, you dig what I'm saying? You got me fucked up that you think you just finna.
But you're a blitzen.
Hey, can I ask you? Ask y'all this?
You're a black citizen.
I'm trying to think of this. I don't recall ever seeing this many white people protest nothing black.
Cause
they
not.
Poor.
Nope.
Yes. The pandemic has them in a different situation than normally, bro. Because protests normally end on
they
Monday.
They poor KKK.
Because people got to go to work.
They poor KKK.
They be like, well, y'all marching tomorrow? Shit, I got to be to work at 10 o'clock.
What do you
mean?
But
ain't nobody
poor
going
KKK.
To work now. So now everybody is fucked up.
Exactly
so
what
now
he said.
They see it.
They poor, but they KKK.
Yeah. But if you're a poor white person, you just a lighter skinned nigga.
Because you when you looting, it's y'all. You ain't fighting for no cause, no Black Lives Matter.
We talking about two different groups. Yeah. I was going to get to the white looters and shit.
But you talking about the white people that's on our side, the protesters.
Yeah, I ain't never seen white people.
They poor KKK. Them niggas too. Just because they ain't through shit, they poor KKK.
I think it's because they poor now. Because they hurting now. They struggling. They been in the house 3 months. Like, white people was grabbing a bunch of shit out of a bunch of places. Like, that Target, like, ain't that many niggas in Minnesota, so they couldn't been doing all the looting. You know what I'm saying? It was white people everywhere getting shit. Patagonia. You know what Patagonia is?
Hell nah. What the
exactly,
fuck
exactly, nigga. You wouldn't even know to take stuff
that?
Out of there. White people took, bro, this, I don't know.
This Patagonia?
See, place where white people stole from is what I call it now.
This like, one, I knew it was white people looting. When the motherfuckers riot and they
just
looted.
Smoking in my face and shit.
Hot topic,
they ain't. Nigga, they burnt down Popeyes. That ain't us. Motherfuckers hitting windows with skateboards. Who on a skateboard? Yeah, a couple of y'all niggas might own skateboards. I ain't gonna lie.
I don't think no nigga own no
skateboard. So niggas don't own no
skateboard. It was a nigga on a skateboard in the van. That nigga hit a pothole, stupid. I watched that nigga.
Nigga spray painting Kill Whitey on shit. There was no real nigga say Kill Whitey. I was like, did Damon Wayans come downtown? The cast of Living Color downtown rioting?
What if it was an old nigga down there, 71? Kill Whitey.
That's what we doing, right?
Bro, it was a white lady downtown had a poster talking about some. Write 2 thoughts on this poster that you think was a change. Man, I'm like, nothing even get this Archie Crab shit. I'm going to kick that hole in the face. Man, ain't no damn poster. What you going to take these thoughts and do, bitch? What you going to tell them 2 thoughts to?
My
thoughts. So stupid ass song. Bitch going to use that up. Talking about, yeah, I had a whole bunch of niggas write their thoughts. Look.
White women been letting us down, bro. They the ones they didn't want to vote for Hillary.
When did white women ever have our confidence to let us?
They voted up for Obama. White women helped with the vote for Obama.
Yeah, they did. You gonna have a whole bunch of black women coming at your ass?
Huh?
You gonna have a whole bunch of black women coming at you?
Because I said white women helped it with Obama and not with Hillary.
I think
they helped them get Trump elected. Like white women let us down.
Tell you
now
who helped I'm gonna tell you who helped Trump get elected. These fake ass folk who ain't with the KKK.
Hey,
bro,
real quick, take that back about the black women getting on me, because I know how they.
All right, black women ain't gonna get on you.
Yeah, nigga, don't
on
do
you.
That.
All right, don't get on them, y'all.
I like my social media where it's at.
But what I'm telling you is, it's so many undercover people that is represented by a particular party. You see what I'm saying? Think about it. All these people that, for him to feel like that was okay to kill, buddy, because you knew he was with a particular party of people. You feel what I'm saying? Even though he's with Bam Bam Bam.
Protected by the gang.
He's got a particular part of people that's with him that he feel like he's going to be scraped regardless. You see what I'm saying? We don't have a particular party of people. Well, we going to be scraped regardless. Dig what I'm saying?
That's what we need. So here's the breakdown on the shit.
Talk your shit. I hear you.
So what we need is justice. The reason we can't get justice is
what is justice?
Well, you're right, because the system is working perfectly, because that's how it's made to work.
Ain't got no switch.
But I'm saying we need different prosecution for these people, because they're expecting motherfuckers to prosecute people that they cool with. They like expecting me to prosecute you. But I've been working with you 5-10 years on my cases that I need help with. So even if I don't work with you, I might work with Fly. I work with somebody you know. And right. If I also prosecute you to the fullest of extent, I will never win another case, because that police department is not finna help me. So you got to have a whole separate entity, just like in Minneapolis now with George Floyd case. They got a special prosecutor on the case now. You know what I'm saying? But at first, it was about to be the homie. It was about to be the homie. So the black lady came in. Yeah, I forgot her name.
Yeah, the fix is already in with the autopsy and all that.
Yeah, what they did say is asphyxiation. They tried to say pre-existing conditions at first.
What the fuck is asphyxiation? That's suffocating?
Choking. Choke. Death, yeah.
Why they just ain't say that?
Because
it's called asphyxiation.
Term for it.
Well, we need it's to start saying term. That. Nigga, you gonna fix, nigga? Don't asphyxiate me, nigga.
Fuck there you go. There you go.
Like, what?
You talking about? There you go.
You knew the word.
There you go.
Don't asphyxiate me.
Yeah, the officer tried to asphyxiate me.
Hold on. You gotta get the A at the beginning.
Asphyxiate. I said it was.
Asphyxiate. Yeah, don't asphyxiate is not gonna get it.
It's AX, ain't it? That's
AX. I mean, it's too much.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Yeah, they ain't
gonna. Hey, fuck that.
Just asphyxiate.
Hey, that's what you call a valiant effort.
That's goddamn right.
You see what I'm saying? But we gotta understand what war that we fighting. We not, nigga, that same goddamn war that we fighting, equality, we understand that. When is the war gonna begin?
What do you mean?
Niggas who understood, no.
No, I'm saying like I'm asking you to go deeper.
Oh, you can come on.
No, I'm not being dumb.
I'm
trying to lead you to talk more shit.
Okay, so
my communication game is off.
Nah, see what we're saying the same thing.
The world got us fucked up
with the older generation. Yeah. Uh-huh. I see where you're going.
Yeah.
That little nigga is stupid. You know the old nigga, they just want you to shut up. I see where you're going. That little nigga, that is stupid.
Nah, we went to you just want to get, yeah, I mean.
No, but you gotta understand, like, we speaking the same language. I understand. I want you to be able to go out there and speak and know you got a force behind you. I want you to be able to go out there and speak and knowing you got a force behind you. Not only you got a force behind you, but I believe in what you're saying, because a lot of people don't believe in what niggas are dying at. If I can get a bullhorn and get 100 niggas behind me, but 50 niggas is probably, together is like, man, that nigga down here talk shit, man. They don't believe you. We gotta actually believe in each other's perspective so our fucking movement can be stronger. Everybody ain't got to be down there yelling. Everybody ain't got to be down there yelling. We can move in unison and have somebody, and it's in order. Once he done, the next person takes the flow.
Yeah.
And once he done, the next person takes the flow.
There are some cities that are doing that already.
You might be 146 that's in line to talk. So until it's your time,
shut
the fuck up and move. Cause they ain't gonna. They gonna hit it for us.
Yeah.
Damn, where they going to? And it ain't got to be announced.
Yeah.
Where we walking and when we meeting up and when we walking.
Right.
You keep putting this shit on social media, they'll find out when they call the news.
Look, just give everybody a password to the same email, write what you got to write in the drafts, and they can't never trace it.
No, it still ain't going to work. This is,
what you mean?
Nope. This is America. There's no way around this.
No,
if all of us got the same email address and we never send the email, we write it in the drafts, I log in to see what you put, look in the draft. Come on, man, cut that part
out. I like that. But then it might be an infiltrator that got the password to the email.
Yeah, that's fine.
That's understandable.
Trick them. Come on, man. We got to be smart. It's a strategy, man.
I'm with that.
That's part of war. Strategy is what you're saying is like where strategy. The war started. Part of war is the strategy.
And we also got
to
be.
You're doing it. You're doing it, nigga. All the stuff you're doing, giving back to your community, making people stronger, making niggas in the hood want to do comedy.
Right.
That's part of the strategy. That's right. Part of building us better. Instead of when we was growing up, the dope boys was the niggas that we looked to.
That was
to.
All our strategy.
I think that somebody that's in power wanted this. Because they let this fester for so long. Like they created a powder keg of just problems for everybody. And then you look at all the things that have happened over the course of, you know, the last 3-4 months.
Yeah.
It's just like they sent out the stimulus check just to start some shit.
Just to start some shit.
You get where y'all get the money from? Nigga been poor for a long ass time.
The country has a lot of money, nigga.
Folk got $500 billion to give it to
500
who?
Trillion.
Just like how you said, it started affecting the white people, right?
Mm-hmm.
When them folks started losing their job, they had a plan to feed them niggas.
Immediately.
But we was amongst the group of people that they
everybody became niggas for Corona.
The
everybody. Everybody had to get on unemployment.
And what happened to Corona once all this happened?
Niggas, that's right, we ain't gonna get into that. I need to be on the revolution. Yeah, man. Fuck that.
Wait a minute, check this out.
Yo, Smokey Blunt, so shit get deeper.
Yeah, man. It's so fucked up. I got a lot of weed and ain't enough weed. It's crazy.
That's what I'm trying to tell you. 40 million people. Unemployed.
Come on.
Nigga,
that's more than black people.
I didn't even know about the recession. I knew it, but I didn't understand it.
You were young.
I didn't understand. I'm like, damn, recession. Oh, I can hear Jesus. But we made it through recession.
Not on the planet.
Like,
in America.
Fuck? Nigga, man, what the fuck is that?
No, I'm saying that's 40 million is more than there are black people on the planet.
40 million, nigga.
It's more than 40 million black people on the planet.
Up.
It's 40 million black people in America.
Okay.
Look it up.
That's another statement I got to look up. But guess what? This is the highest unemployment rate, and it was higher than the recession.
That time, right? Right.
You see what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
So the social media can cover up a lot
of
shit.
We were headed towards a recession anyway, so this shit is like double trouble.
Bigger.
Yeah, so they got
it's bigger than the first recession.
It's going further than we want it to go, so we're going to have to goddamn.
Now, think about this.
Curtail something.
Detroit went up under the recession and still been trying to bounce back for the longest.
Right.
You dig what I'm saying? So it's like, we don't want them folk to come up with a plan and then we still been just trying to fight to work again. You see what I'm saying? Just to even work. So now that we can work, Black Wall Street, I'm gonna keep hitting you in your motherfucking face. Now that you're able to work, let's spend the dollars with each other.
I think that's perfect.
Spend them with each other.
Spend them with each other. Because I think that's what this whole thing is about, dog. I think they tried to level out the economy because there are more entrepreneurs now than there have ever been.
It definitely is. Motherfuckers walking. Niggas got big.
And they was like, hold on, this is getting out of control. We can't find where everybody getting their money from. Nobody's
that's why they doing
the
census and shit.
Get.
They trying to figure out how many niggas in your house. You know what I'm saying? You got a barbershop, a salon. How many people in your goddamn house, man? They feel like everything in the trap. We just gotta
be fair, they've been doing the census, but
we ain't been answering them, nigga. How many people in your house? If you don't keep fucking walking, bitch ass nigga, we see that ass.
Hey,
with no pants.
Wait a minute. According to the research department, there are 1.2 billion Africans. There are 37 million African Americans in the motherfucker.
37 million.
That's what I said.
That's under 40.
How many white people?
That's under 40.
How many white people?
It was 40 million black people in the world.
You know what?
You did say that, nigga.
On this shit, we got to be all positive.
I'm just showing you my research department.
No, he only thought about
more black. Hey, nigga, did y'all get this camera fixed right here? Whichever one that had these looking like this all the time on the motherfucker.
The glitching.
No, that was because we was doing a live stream.
Oh, okay. That shit was tripping me out.
Testing out a new system.
I was like, oh, this shit is
we don't fuck with that technology. All right,
cool, cool.
When you said it ain't but 40 million black people in the world, look at Marvin Gaye start looking at you.
Fuck you.
Marvin Gaye was like, man, this nigga.
I want a woman that listens. Hey, bro, I knew I shouldn't have said,
y'all niggas set niggas up. I was like, why fly me sitting way over there?
Marvin Gaye. Marvin Gaye be judging niggas.
I get it. That's a mean.
No,
really,
to be honest, Marvin Gaye made us realize he was there. It was like some shit had that went on, and we looked at him, we were like, hell no. And he was like, nigga, yeah. I told y'all.
I been trying to tell y'all.
So I'm like, we heard you, Bob.
Oh, man. So you got a plan, Fly?
I do.
What is it your plan?
It ain't meant to be told to everybody.
Oh. I really just want to know if you had one.
Yes. And it's not only just.
But that what we need.
It's not only just a plan. I can say this. It's a group of people.
Mm-hmm.
Not only we not have a plan, we also have a destination.
There you go.
Because a lot of people want to be leaders, but where are you leading your people?
Right.
You feel me? You're going to be like, let's go over here. And then once we done fought so hard to get over here,
yeah.
Then they're like, now what's next? Because I'm going to be 100. It's a lot of people that don't mind being guided.
Mm-hmm.
That don't mind being guided. And it's a lot of people that's having to say so. But we want to let people know that we respect your mm-hmm. opinion. And we're going to add your opinion to the agenda
right.
that we got. Now, when you out there fighting, you ain't just fighting for, oh man, we fighting because Charlotte didn't want to be out here. Nah, man, I'm for adding my opinion to the agenda, nigga.
Right.
So I know they
I'm
with
fighting
me.
For my shit
nigga,
now.
I'm fighting for my shit now, even though we out here together. Mm-hmm. Nigga, we out here together. You dig what I'm saying? Right. If it's all of us in this room right now, nigga, if everybody write their problem on a piece of paper, nigga, and we put all every
you sound like
problem
a white bitch at the protest.
Hell no! Hell right no! Because she doing that for show.
I know, fuck.
You see what I'm saying? She doing that for show. She talking about some write this shit on a poster, and then you go home. Like, we ain't, you right. talking about writing a problem. Right, I'm asking you what's your problem and what's your contact. You brother, you dig what I'm saying? Because not only, I'm letting movement. You know, nigga, your shit got a voice.
Yeah.
And then you can come somewhere where you feel like you got a voice. You dig what I'm saying? Yeah, you yelling, but we finna show you how to organize and structure that yelling.
And I don't tell no grown man what to do, but I also suggest you, this is the time you use your rich friends for the resources as well. Okay, we can move on.
We definitely need some resources. And some opportunities.
That's the only way you can fight a war.
That's how the
resources.
Bank started. That's how the fund.
Everything, nigga. It's you can't fund. Be president without resources.
It's a fund. We have a fund. Where y'all getting this shit from? We have a fund.
And it's more than just resources. It's more than just money. You know what I'm saying? It's real estate. It's not.
Talk your shit.
It's lawyers. It's police,
access.
Our police officers. But this how. The, but you this, got four or five homeboys from your hood.